Why do you guys think dealers decided to start their own businesses? What do you think they wanted?
They wanted to be their own boss.
Absolutely. A little bit of freedom. What else?
More time.
More time, absolutely. And there's a third one. And you guys just nailed it out of the gate.
Make their own money.
There you go. Literally, every entrepreneur starts their business for the same reason. They want more time, more money, and more freedom. You guys, as you visit with dealers and you get to know them, how many of them do you think feel like they got more time, money, and freedom when they launched these businesses?
You think not many.
Not many. Right. That is the challenge with not just dealers, with all entrepreneurs. Every entrepreneur starts their business thinking, hallelujah, I'm going to drop the W-2 and my old gig, and I'm going to have all my time, all my money, and all my freedom to myself. And then they get into business and learn that it's hard. Real hard. They typically dump all of their cash, their money. Sometimes these guys will take out loans. Sometimes they'll mortgage their houses, max their credit cards in order to achieve this dream, this thing of having more time, money, and freedom. And all the while, the majority of them are expert tradesmen. They're expert at something specific, which doesn't necessarily mean that they're experts at running a business. So the amount of things you're going to uncover over time with dealers as you get to know them, in order to create a successful entrepreneur who creates more time, money, and freedom, it's going to cover sales. It's going to cover marketing. It's going to cover finance. It's going to cover all of these other elements. We have to figure out how to put systems and processes and provide education so that these dealers can fill the gaps, so that they can plug up all of those holes that may be slowing them down, maybe causing them to burn through cash, maybe causing them to work 24/7, or the majority of dealers that have sat inside an audience that I've spoke to, and I asked them what the last vacation was, and their wife was sitting in the room saying that the dealer meeting they were attending that moment is the vacation. Does that sound like a good vacation to y'all? Dealer meeting?
Yeah, not very fun, like.
So we've got to get, and this is, I think, something that, you know, when we're building relationships with our dealer network, is really trying to understand. And luckily, it's pretty easy to understand why every entrepreneur does what they do, because it's the entrepreneur way. So you don't have to guess. Whether they're upfront about the fact that they feel like they have time, money, and freedom or not, that's a different story. And that comes with trust and confidence in the relationship you guys build with them. So we're going to concentrate heavily on how to leverage technology, how to build their brand, how to establish a reputation that's good, that's strong, how to get in front of consumers that are looking to buy what they are willing to sell, where they're willing to sell it,